Let's see, in the sake of time, I'm going to skip to a craft talk that we have today from Sarah. Sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off, Sophie. I really appreciate you. I'll try to get you in
the time.
But that whole time thing kind of sticks up on you. So yeah, without further ado, Sarah.
So happy to be
here.
So, hello. I was born in Fortuna, California in 1882. This is my family, and I'm that little girl on the, you know, back in the 80s, everybody had the long hair, but the man with the long hair with the beard, and that's my mom right in front of me, and my little sister with the blonde hair. So that's me with a bird. So when I was around 4 or 5 years old, my mom and dad split up and I moved to Oakdale, California, which is near Modesto. I lived there for a couple years, San Jose, Riverdale, San Jose, Oakdale. And then I moved back up to Humboldt County in 1998. So I'm one of four. On the left there, on the top left, is my brother and my sister, Jalissa. They're half siblings. And then my sister and I, in the center, the brown hair and the blonde hair, we're full siblings. The same dad. I had a little dark period when I was in junior high school. You can see that. So I got married right after high school at 18 years old. I had my daughter and then I started College of the Redwoods. This is a family reunion photo. That was really cute. This is my mother. And so when I started College of the Redwoods with the 12-month little baby, I thought that what I wanted to do really was to be a preschool teacher, because that's like the one thing that you can do and take your child to work with you. I really didn't want to put her in daycare. So there's some really good mentors out there. There was a brand new lab that was developing that was specially designed to teach people how to be teachers, and there was like Cheryl Rao and Sydney Larson and all kinds of people that were like super prominent members in the community that knew a lot about child development. And so they had this mentorship thing. And Cheryl was my mentor. And I'd come in, I'd say, I want to get 12 units to get a preschool teacher license. And she's like, no, you want to get at least 24 units to get your teacher. Because it was like associate teacher or teacher. And every time I went up in there, she would like encourage me to take more classes and take more classes. So eventually I'm like, finally, I'll get my associate's degree. So I kept going to school. I got a job there as a teacher, as an assistant teacher, and then I bumped up to full-time, full teacher. And I got pregnant again with my son, Asher. We kind of look alike. So this is my daughter on the left. She's now 16 years old, and my son, Asher, is when she graduated 8th grade. She's a little bit taller than me. There's my niece, Shiley. At some point during my childhood, my sister continued to have children. She had about 7 children. Wow. And so as I was going through preschool education, I was also kind of turning into a social worker. And so as a preschool teacher, you kind of like have to be a parent educator or social worker. You hand out free clothes, whatever a family needs. You just kind of mutate into this like teacher, social worker kind of thing. And so I realized doing that, that I had a passion for helping families. And so when I transferred from CR to Humboldt State, because as a preschool teacher, you don't make very much money, and I started to have problems with my marriage, and I realized that I'm going to probably be the one that has to support my family. And so instead of being a teacher where I could only impact the child and maybe the parent, I decided I wanted to be more of an intervention for families, because that's really where you can see the truth change. So this is Asher's Boy Scout group. So around the time when I decided to join Rotary, I decided to join him in Boy Scouts, because I feel like to make an impact on the community, it starts from the beginning. You really have to start teaching children from the very beginning. So as it's kind of jumping around, because I'm a little bit scattered. But my daughter also takes part of a Native American ceremony. My ex-husband is Wiyot, and so my children are, or he's half, my children are a quarter, and that's Grandma Leona. She's a very big part of my life. We kind of lived right next door to her the whole time that I was with my husband, so for like 10 years, she was my best friend. big part of my life as well. So I kind of like load a lot on my plate all the time. So going through school, I decided to do social work instead of education just so I could make a bigger impact. But I also started Taekwondo when I was an undergrad. So sometimes it seems like there's not enough time in the day to do everything you need to do. So I also love to travel. Part of being single for the first time as an adult was me also exploring the larger world. So we went to Australia, been to Niagara Falls. This is in Australia at one of the museums. I started Taekwondo in 2009, like right around the time that I left my husband. This academy has really built my leadership skills even more. Like as being a preschool teacher wasn't enough. I also kind of built my character here in this school. And so as the academy was starting, he also went through some transitions and some instructors left. And so I kind of like built into the academy as an instructor. And so this is my Tiny Tiger group testing in front of the black belts at one of the testings about 2 or 3 years ago. We do women's self-defense seminars sometimes, not as much as people would like, but you know, we're all busy. These are some of the instructors, Master Corey Lewis in the center with the bald head, Kelly Leahy on the right, and Travis Holter on the left, and we're the four of the instructors there. So as I got my bachelor's degree in child development, I found a job as an early Head Start home visitor. It's kind of like a hybrid of preschool teaching along with social work. This is my group of coworkers. Amber Van Dunk is there in the center, and she was my supervisor. So I worked for like 2.5 years at Early Head Start before I started my master's degree in social work at Humboldt State. I graduated in 2016. This is my cohort. It was really small, it was like 13 people, and then as we brought in the advanced standing students, it went up to like 20-something, but social work degrees are really intimate settings. And it's really a nice experience to be surrounded by people that all have a common, like, common goals and common frame of mind. Like, we, of course, didn't always get along, but it was a really great experience. So I started at Humboldt County Social Services in 2016. While I was an undergrad, I also did an internship as a school counselor. So I might mutate into something like that. I'm also studying for my license test to become an LCSW. I take the law and ethics exam tomorrow. And so eventually I'd like to be a counselor of young children and specialize with 0 to 8. And then as I work through that, because I think that people need to constantly evolve their careers, I'll probably do college teaching at some